Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we'll represent conjugation and multiplication of complex numbers on complex plane. Now we know that any number of the form x plus iota y, where x and y are real numbers, is called a complex number. And here x is called the real part and y is called the imaginary part of the complex number x plus iota y. Now we know that the complex number x plus y iota can be represented by the ordered pair xy, and this complex number can be represented in this complex plane where x-axis is called the real axis and y-axis is called the imaginary axis. As real part of the complex number is represented as a point on the x-axis and imaginary part of the complex number is represented by the point on the y-axis. Thus, the complex numbers are represented on this complex plane. Now let us discuss conjugation of complex numbers in complex plane. Now, if z is equal to x plus iota y is any complex number, then its conjugate is given by z bar or z star, which is equal to x minus y iota or x minus iota y. Thus, in conjugate, the sign of imaginary part is changed. Now we will draw the complex number and its conjugate on the complex plane. Now let the complex number z is equal to 2 plus 3 iota and its conjugate, that is z bar, is equal to, now here we will change the sign of imaginary part, so its conjugate will be 2 minus 3 iota. Now we will draw both z and z bar on the complex plane. First of all, let us draw the complex number 2 plus 3 iota. Now from origin we will move 2 units right and 3 units up, and we reach at this point. So this is the point P with coordinates 2, 3, and it represents the complex number 2 plus 3 iota. Now let us represent its conjugate on the complex plane, that is z bar is equal to 2 minus 3 iota. Now here, from origin O, we will move 2 units right and 3 units down and reach at this point. Let this point be Q with coordinates 2, minus 3. It represents conjugate of complex number z, that is z bar, which is equal to 2 minus 3 iota. Now let us see the two complex numbers. Here you can see that the point Q is the reflection of point P in x-axis, that is the real axis. Thus, when we have to draw conjugate of complex number in the complex plane, then we simply reflect H in real axis. Now let us discuss multiplication of complex numbers in complex plane. Now we will use polar form of the complex numbers to show multiplication. Now we know that the polar form of a complex number is given by Z is equal to R into cos theta plus iota sin theta the whole, where R is the modulus of the complex number and theta is the argument of the complex number. Now let Z1 is equal to R1 into cos alpha plus iota sin alpha the whole, and Z2 is equal to R2 into cos beta plus iota sin beta the whole be two complex numbers. Now let us find their product Z1 into Z2, or Z1 Z2, which is equal to R1 into cos alpha plus iota sin alpha the whole into R2 into cos beta plus iota sin beta the whole. This is equal to R1 R2 into cos alpha plus iota sin alpha the whole into cos beta plus iota sin beta the whole. Now let us open the brackets. So this is equal to R1 R2 into cos alpha cos beta plus iota cos alpha sin beta plus iota sin alpha cos beta plus, now iota into iota will be iota square, into sin alpha sin beta the whole. Now we know that iota square is equal to minus 1. So this will be equal to R1 R2 into cos alpha cos beta plus iota cos alpha sin beta plus iota sin alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta the whole, as iota square is minus 1. Now combining real and imaginary parts, this is equal to R1 R2 into cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta. Now for these two terms, taking iota common, it will be plus iota into cos alpha sin beta plus sin alpha cos beta the whole, and this complete whole. Now using this trigonometric formula, cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta will be equal to cos alpha plus beta. So this is equal to R1 R2 into cos of alpha plus beta the whole, and using this trigonometric formula, cos alpha sin beta plus sin alpha cos beta will be equal to sin alpha plus beta. So here we have plus iota sin of alpha plus beta the whole, and this complete whole. Thus we have obtained the product Z1 Z2, which is again a complex number with modulus R1 R2 and amplitude or argument alpha plus beta. Thus we see that product of two complex numbers is again a complex number whose amplitude is sum of the arguments of the two complex numbers, and modulus is the product of very long of two numbers, that is the two complex numbers. So geometrically its representation will be like this. This is the point P representing complex number Z1. Its modulus is R1 and argument or amplitude is alpha. Point Q represents complex number Z2 whose modulus is R2 and argument is beta. Point R will represent complex number given by Z1, Z2 and will have modulus R1, R2 and argument alpha plus beta. So this is the geometrical representation of multiplication of complex numbers in complex plane. So in this session we have discussed how to represent conjugation and multiplication of complex numbers on complex plane. And this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.